everyone?
Good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Good morning. Good. Good.
All right. So, Kim, you've been around camp for weeks. Is there anything specific that you've been, any specific either groups or players that you've been trying to prioritize seeing throughout the first week of camp as guys start settling in?
Yeah, some of the newer players, players I don't know that well. So, you know, watching Gene Segura, Johnny Cueto's bullpen, watching Luis Arraez out in the field as well as his BP. And just making, you know, just watching some of the pitchers, seeing if they can make sure that they're healthy, they look good. Just that I think the club is ready to take that next step. In terms of, you know, Skip and the staff that we hired, those guys are prepared and eager, ready, and willing to lead them, and that they're not going to leave any stone unturned in terms of helping them with their development and trying to put up a win every night on the board.
Do you feel that coming back from Washington, from the players for Washington?
From what I've heard, it's been really positive, a really positive environment. There's definitely an energy and an enthusiasm right now.
Well, Kim, I know Brazoban had the visa issue. Any update with him and is everybody else here who's supposed to be here?
Yes, as far as I know, everybody else is here that's supposed to be here, but no update on Brazoban.
Kim, just starting year three in your long-term vision, what processes that you have implemented are you starting to see results from in your role?
Yeah, I think it's... the next week or so to talk about. I mean, I would just say throughout the operation, I think we've seen some changes. I think we've seen some adjustments made in how we go about some items, how we think about some items. I think Skip and his staff coming from, that's one of the exciting things. Skip and his staff come from a number of different organizations. Several of them are winning organizations and had a lot of success on a good number of fronts. So getting those guys in-house so that we have a diverse perspective in how we look at, how we evaluate, how we go through those processes has been invaluable to this point. And I suspect that going forward, it's going to add a ton of value.
Do you feel, Kim, that the new schedule will be beneficial for the Marlins?
I do. I think in some ways it'll be valuable, but even though we're not going to play as many teams from the NL East, definitely there are other good divisions out there, so it will help a bit, but maybe not as much as we wanted to.
And how about the new rules? Is there any rules that you like and you think would be a big package?
I think overall, in terms of the pitch clock, I think that's great for the game. I know the commissioner's office, the commissioner himself, has worked very, very hard on some of these rule changes for a number of years. I do think the pitch clock will help the game in general. When you talk to the minor leaguers about their experience, it's really just getting used to it. And now I think they're pretty happy with the product. And that is reduction. I want to say it's 25-30 minutes. And then I think, the bigger bags will help a club like ours. We've got some base stealers, in Jazz, Joey Wendell, John Birdie obviously led the National League in stolen bases last year. So I think it can help a club like ours.
There's nobody from the junior year class that wants to make it. Created that or figured that out? Is it developing? Is it drafting?
I don't really break it down like that. I mean, they're all Marlins players, and so I'd have to take a look.
A couple times you've been in this sort of different regions and whatnot. Is that something early on figured that they didn't want to do the other team organization, or something that you wanted to?
Can you repeat again?
Yeah, like I think when you brought in Oz, you had mentioned bringing different regions a couple minutes ago. Is that something you saw like you needed this organization?
No, I wouldn't say it was needed, but I'd definitely say it's of value, and was happy that I did it.
Kim, how much harder does it make your
can only control what we can control. So I look at our club, I look at our guys, I look at the tone of our camp, and I'm pretty happy about where we are right now.
We've got more time, of course, but at this point, do you feel like you've done enough in the offseason to set this club up for a good season?
I'm not sure you're ever satisfied, but I think in terms of, you know, the additions that we've made, you know, between, you know, Gene Segura, who is in the World Series, Johnny Cueto, who had a nice year, you know, Luis Arraez, who was the hitting champ of the American League last year, yeah, I feel we had a pretty good offseason. I think it'll be a strength. You know, I think we're always concerned, you know. I think, you know, it was part of the calculus, and, you know, but I would also say that if we didn't think that they could do it, we wouldn't have done it.